Bomb AF, aka Bomb and Fabulous Stuffed Bell Peppers.
A little jalapeno for the spice. I'm gonna add some brown rice and then add a little tomato paste as well and some seasonings to put it all together and stuff them with brown rice. So this should be a very fabulous and delicious meal. Here are the red bell peppers. I've got them all prepared, decored, seeds out. They're fabulous. They're super large. So excited to make it. Traditional recipes usually have you do the brown rice so it's not cooked, but I have cooked brown rice that I wanted to use, so I want to make sure I don't waste it. And so I'm just going to go ahead and incorporate all of that and then stir it through here. But let me blend everything together, get it going, and show you some more next steps. Yum. It's looking rather sensational, I would say, wouldn't you guys? I went ahead and added some really small chopped asparagus as well. So we've got portobellos, asparagus, of course the onion, a little jalapeno. And then in terms of seasonings, I added a little bit of liquid aminos to give it that umami flavor, as well as some garlic, crushed red pepper, a little salt-free McCormick's, and ground paprika, and then of course a little tomato paste. So now it's time for me to add the brown rice. Here we go. Here are the spices, seasonings that I use, everything to put the flavor together. Now let's take a look. How's that looking, guys? It's phenomenal. Ready to stuff the bell peppers. I've got the oven preheated to 425, and it should be
25 minutes.
Let's get it done. Ooh, yum. Okay, one last photo. Video, I mean, of how amazing it's gonna look before I stuff them into the bell peppers. I don't know that I want to add cheese to this, so just so you guys know, you can add a vegan cheese if you like. I'm trying to do completely minimally processed. I do have like a cheese sauce, but it's more of a nacho cheese sauce that I could do as a vegan cheese sauce, but I think I'm just gonna go ahead and do them without the cheese. I might change my mind, you never know. But I also added large chopped baby portobellos in there, so it's just got a little bit more of a different texture, so it's gonna be really meaty and dense. Check it out, guys. They are not done, apparently, obviously, but this is what they look like pre-oven. I'm so excited about these, I just have to show you. Yes. These are amazing. And now the recipe that I used calls for parsley, but I love to have like that Latin kick to it. I added jalapenos and I did add a little bit of cumin and cilantro to top instead of parsley. Let's put them in the oven. Final product. Look how amazing it looks. Plant-based stuffed bell peppers. Super easy, super delicious, guys. It smells amazing. Looks phenomenal. Look at that. You can see it's steaming. So good. Can't wait to dig in, guys. Yum. I'll add the ingredients and the instructions below. Try it and let me know what you think. I'm going to taste this so that you know from the look on my face how amazing and delicious this is. Ooh. So excited, guys. Make sure to get the asparagus, portobello, and some of the rice on here, too. Phenomenal. The flavor is exceptional. So good. Not too salty. Enough seasoning. And I'm getting a little bit of the heat from the red pepper flake and the jalapeno. But the flavor, oh my god, it's phenomenal. It really, because of the portobellos, has such a meaty texture and the flavor to die for. I recommend you make some now.
super bomb, guys. This is actually the inside of the stuffed bell pepper leftovers that I had. And I'm gonna do lettuce wraps. Yes. So good with jalapenos, because you know I love a spicy, so yum. And then I'm gonna top it with this amazing vegan hot sauce that I have. It's a creamy hot sauce. Oh my god, I'll show you the finished product. Yum. So this is the finished product. Vegan lettuce wraps with the stuffed bell pepper filling. And this is the sauce that I use. Blue top over the top. Ghost ranch creamy street dressing made out of coconut milk. Yes. So send your location, come. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please like, share, subscribe. Let me know if you have any feedback. Would love to hear your version of the recipes, how they worked for you. And yeah, let's do it again. Yakky's Eats.